Matthew chapter 23, verse 9. And call no man your father upon the earth, for one is your father, which is in heaven. And this is, you know, let us try to actually get to the question, right? And so this is, our fellow brother or sister, he only asked a question, and a good one at that. But what we're about to say is kind of like, it's how we think that this verse and our testimony could be potentially viewed as a contradiction amongst the unlearned. And so they would think, the unlearned would kind of be like, see, how come you call His Imperial Majesty your father, and Geta Jesus clearly makes mention not to do so. And you know, right from the start, we thought about this, and without doing any research, we kind of thought, well, actually, our Father, he is in heaven, and so, like, whether it be the higher heights or in all of creation, but you know, that would cause a technicality, and that would, in most cases, lead I and I to have to put I guess kind of like put in doubt the humanity of our God and Father. And so we knew that this had to be researched, like, actuality, not just, you know, thinking of shortcuts on how to address this question, right? And so let us go right into it. And so, man, I mean, we can't stop giving thanks how much we learned from this question, because from a few weeks ago, we've been trying to get into the whole quantum of language, the quantums of language, but we understood it, but we wanted to, like, go deep into it, but something within I and I kind of, like, did not allow for us to make that move. And turns out, after researching this verse, it turns out that we kind of, like, we got the answer as to how to go about it, and it's all thanks to that question. And so it this really helped a lot. So, and on the personal note, we give thanks once more, because this in fact we can say that we have a better understanding of quantum language, the mechanics of the quantum languages, and we know how to go about it to continue our research now, without it being in a manner in which we are not interested in. And by that we mean in any other spirit that is not in Jesus Christo. It's like we didn't want to go out and research the quantums of language through just, like, the worldly perspective. We knew that if we began, it would be boring, we would be discouraged, and so we held on to just thinking about it and pausing it and delaying the actual researching. And thanks to this great question, it's like, okay, we don't have to deal with all that nonsense that we don't want to deal with, and we could just go straight to the word, of truth, and we'll get our answers here. And that makes it easier for I and I to know the quantums of language, because we enjoy studying the word of truth, and so we give much thanks for that. So let us watch. We're gonna read on how it would sound in the Greek or Latin, Greek, I believe, and so. It would sound something like this, kai or ki, kai kalio, mi human, pater, epige, gar hais esti, human, pater, ho en, uranos. And so, that's how it would sound. And let us just break it down, being it's only one verse, right? And so, and no need into going into and is kind of like trying to and add it to the prior, but if we're doing if we're doing our own paperwork, I would recommend that we don't include unnecessary words like and. It's like if there's a period, then you know that the sentence that is to follow is an addition. It's additional to the one previously written. And so I personally don't feel the need to have to write and. So let us continue, and no need to go into it. And call in this case, it's actually pretty much what ones would assume call is. And so it's the naming, the numbering, the commanding, the appointing. And so it's basically the call that we all understand in this worldly confusion. And so no need to go into that. And the next word is and call no. And so no is the first word that kind of opened the window of opportunities to overstanding to begin in the overstanding process of the quantums of language. No in the Greek is me. And so as soon as we saw that, it's like, okay, we know where this is going. We're gonna have fun, and this is gonna be great. Watch, I'll share the thought that came to mind as soon as we saw me. Okay, this means that whenever we, here in this confusion Babylon system, when we say me, we're saying no. And so it just came to mind immediately. So if I'm talking to a judge and I'm testifying and I say that bicycle belongs to me, the judge is listening to I say that, which is a positive affirmation. Bicycle, it's I don't know if the by meaning to is gonna cancel the cycle, but let us pretend that it doesn't. So affirming, and the noun, the actual material of substance, the merchandise, would be bicycle. Affirming bicycle belongs. Okay, belongs, I don't know, I didn't go into that word or anything, it's just an example, but the fact that it be before longs is probably going to cancel out whatever longs means, so it's going to be like no long. But, you know, for the sake of an example, let us pretend that belong actually means what we think it means. But more correctly, we should use a word like, not even pertain, not even own, but more like I'm guessing inheritance, but in is no, so heritance, so no no inheritance. So it would be more like heritage. I mean, this is just an assumption, just a guess, but just from the little I know, it's gonna result being something of that, of something similar. So it's gonna be like affirmative, positive affirmation, bicycle, material substance, merchandise, belongs, let's pretend belongs means, inherited or heritage, I mean, which is insinuating that it is, you are its possessor, and so belongs to is kind of a technicality, because we don't know if it's talking about to the number or going to, or I want to, or, you know, and so that's a technicality in itself. But let us, being that we're not even learned in this all that much, let us pretend that it is what the judges and the lawyers pretend it is. And so belongs or heritage to me. So the judge is hearing you say, okay, so that bicycle belongs to not, to no, belongs to, so it's not even conclusive. And so the judge is, you know, if it be his will, he's just gonna rule against you. He just declared and testified that bicycle is not his, or at least he's not even sure who it belongs to. All he knows, he can affirm that bicycle is owned by not, by who knows, by, it could be him, could be, so these are the technicalities that we're confronted with in this Babylon system, we're going to go ahead and say that the Latin and the Greek, they're all slave languages. I'm guessing. It's an assumption. It's an opinion. Do your research. I haven't done research, but it's a you know, I'm a go I'm a I'm gonna t I'm gonna take this on faith, right? But eventually I'll do the study, right? But I'll present it as a language of enslavement, but definitely what might be able to be easily proven that is in fact wholly purposed in enslaving the mind, is using Greek and Latin translations in a Shakespearean experience or fake experience, to produce the Bible, the King James Version. This is really, really, I mean, we gotta hand it to them. This is really clever what they have done, but and so in the beginning was a word, I'm guess well no I'm not guessing that right, but I'm what I'm about to go into. So we know that the logos, the logic, was the beginning. And so these individuals, to enslave the minds of the majorities, so-called minorities, used the word, the logic, and they fooled around with it. They tricked. They turned it into a trick. And so now, because they can reference Latin and Greek definitions and roots, origin of words, then they can play this game where white supremacy controls the world, and they are vastly outnumbered, but still they manage to keep the multitudes, the majorities, so-called. Well, basically, they keep the majorities thinking and believing and accepting that they are in fact the minority. And that is fact. I mean, that is evidence in itself of what amount of power these white supremacists exercise. And so, that being said, and then I mean, Shakespeare, it turns out that he invested money in what was it, Virginia? He had plantation. He had money invested in slave owning and slave driving, plantation, I guess, like prisons here in the so-called colonies and stuff like that. So I mean, just gives you an idea of what kind of people put in some efforts into this. And so let us continue. So okay, we didn't even go into the word. I mean, it's so interesting, right? So me, it means no. But to give examples of that more specifically, it's referring to ye, thou. It's a pronoun. It's added in opposition in order to define it more sharply. Thou being a Jew is an example. And so this is saying, like, and so no. Wait, hold on. Excuse that 1 second. Okay, we may have scribbled some. Oh, my bad. Yeah, no, it does apply. So it's or when several are addressed at the same time, particularized. So it's meaning, so no is actually kind of like meaning, like, in a sense, not you individuals. And so, but the it sounds confusing, but the technicality in that is the negativity. And so let us continue. And it's also an antithesis, an opposition. In other words, if it be thou and not an apparition, like, I guess, kind of playing with that whole, if it's you or make believe, the whole not being able to conclusively affirm. And so, or when a particle is added at the close of an argument, when the discourse reverts to the person to be directly addressed. And so we'll go into an example of that. Actually, my bad. This was actually defining the next word. So we apologize for that, but we'll make it right now. Okay, so no would be me implying a negative. More correctly, excuse I, like we said, we're not learnt in this, but we're trying to put it out because it's necessary. Implying a negative adverb, infinitive. So that, at least that part was accurate. After verse of saying, declaring, denying, commanding, no definite person. And so we could see the relationship from call, no. And so it's a negative adverb after the verb of saying, declaring, denying, commanding, no definite person. So this goes to anyone, them that don't, a person who went. I guess those are examples. Conditional, removing particle from thought, fear of doubt. Okay, this is where we have to a key point. Conditional, removing particle from thought, fear of doubt, in is used reference made merely to thought of those or some lack these things or of. Okay, basically what we're trying to say, it's no is a negative adverb, but it's a definite. Oh my bad. It's a wow. This really is confusing. This really is confusing. Speak technically. It denies simply, absolutely, categorically, but denies the thought of the thing or the thing according to judgment, opinion, will, purpose, preference of someone, hence indirectly, subjectively, hypothetically. Okay, okay, we're gonna, I guess the notes kind of confused us. But this kind of no, I think it's like, it's in a sense like a reverse of what we should be. You see, we, a negative adverb that is infinitive is open to doubt, and therefore you cannot prove conclusively without beyond reasonable doubt, right? And so we have to be either let our yay be yay or our nay be nay. And so this is kind of leaving room for doubt and for breathing space for the wicked. I and die is kind of to be the complete opposite of that. And so to better explain that is what this is saying, all that kind of nonsense that we read over, what it's inferring is when one turns a declaration into a we make it conditional because of whatever condition it may be, because someone in the audience may not agree or lacks the knowledge or doesn't believe the same thing. So basically this is kind of like this is important to go into, because we are not to be in such a, we are not to be doing such things. For example, to better clarify this, if we're speaking to an individual, it's like this, putting this into play, into effect in our daily lives would be like you're talking about His Imperial Majesty to someone, and then you allow for whatever they're standing to convert your affirmation into indecisive or infinitive, not definite, by you submitting to their opinion and kind of like saying, well, yeah, technically His Imperial Majesty would be considered God because of this. See, you're kind of like you're falling from grace. You're completely you've just what's it called? Well, you got no more standing, right? Because you're compromising. You're open to conditions because of whatever the outside influence might be or might think or might say, whatever the case may be. So it's when you get into these indefinite arguments to when our yay should be yay, and it should be like His Imperial Majesty Qedamawii Haile Selassie is God. He's the fulfillment of scripture, or at least what pertains to him. And so that is the way that we are to respond. So we are, I guess this kind of got confusing, but it's still good to learn. We have to be like completely certain and not care what people think. I don't care if you're a Muslim, and it's not to disrespect no other people, but it's how we Rastafari are supposed to be, whether they be Catholic. Oh, well, if I say it that way, then it might hurt their feelings. And so that is an example of no, of me, right? And so there's a reason we went into that. We apologize for not executing all that well. Nonetheless, we hope it helps. And so with that, let us continue. So the next word would be, we really apologize for that. We had meditated something else. this is the key. This is where the answer to that question, how come is it right to call a man father, being that Jesus so called mentioned, stated against that, declared that to be wrong. In fact, the word man, your, is the same, one and the same. Man does not belong there. Man is just added. This is where Babylon creeps in, where the serpent creeps in with all their tricks and gimmicks. You see, this is saying you, ye, particularized, like specifically, you right there, you here. Call no man, call no you here. So it's not implying a man as in an existing, of someone existing, a being, you know, one being who we be. This is not inferring to what we would call a human being or a person. But that, even that is interesting, because the word for man, yours, man, I mean, cancel man out of that. That's part of the game and tricks. Nowhere in this verse is it referring to like a being upon earth, like a man. So it's confusing, because, you know, words mean this and they say it means that, but yeah, man is definitely not included in there. This is only addressing, and call no you specifically. And so watch, we'll give an example of this. And so if we open up our scriptures to Matthew 16, verse 28, it reads, verily I say to you, there be some standing here which shall not taste of death till they see the Son of Man coming in his kingdom. And so there be some here is the same as man yours. So I mean, this is so critical, so important for us to see how in the Greek it is possible that, and verily I say to you, there be some standing here is the same as man yours. All of those words mean the same as man yours. I mean, do the math. But even, I mean, this is interesting, even because there be some standing here, standing, some that will not affirm an affirmation and then make it no contract or cancel the affirmation by applying conditions and technicalities and what's it called, when you kind of work out a deal and compromising. And so, and even we could even use this to prove eternity, but we're not going to do that, because we're probably going to go off into something else. But there's a reason why it's saying you here specifically, because we'll just throw it out there, because you here specifically will be there specifically in the times to come. Whomever wishes not to accept the resurrection and the fact of everlasting life and eternity, then you do err. And if I err, it'd be really, really kind of the individuals that possess the knowledge to present it to I, so that I could go forward and correct myself. But we'll just state for the record that we've known since the foundations in the world of the world, since we were a youth, up until right around the age of six, right around when the system of when the so-called miseducation system slapped it or beat it out of us for just for a while until we bought into death. As soon as the miseducational system slapped it or beat it out of us, roughly around the age of six and onward, up until we bore witness to the Father, and then eventually were directed to the Son, and so we overcame once more, because we had taken on death for only a few years, right? Buying into the idea of death. But before that, we were well aware that death was not possible, and we would testify to that openly. And so now I testify to it again. After the overcoming of death, death is not existent, at least for I and I, that is true. I testify that if we have been granted the privilege and honor of testifying and bearing witness to the Father, then we know it for a fact that we were definitely with the Son since the foundations of the world, and there is no way around it. I mean, if ones want to put up an argument, it'd be interesting, but this is our truth. One example would be, some individuals receive Christ, they don't have the Father, and probably will never have the Father, aren't even looking for a Father. Some have the Father, and they say Selassie and Rasta and whatever, right? But they will never bear witness to the, well, hopefully they do, but unfortunately many will never bear witness to the Son, because they weren't there since the foundations. They may have caught on to certain good influences, but it is only those that were given to the Son since the beginning that the Son made a place for us with the Father, and then the Father, being that originally since the foundation we were for the Son, we were handed over to the Son again. And so that is the fulfillment of I and I as Rastafari. We go back to the Son, and that's when it all makes sense. And that's why His Imperial Majesty is not going around saying, follow me, follow this, because we belong to the Son. And all glory be through the Son. And by doing so, the Father inevitably is raised on high and glorified. But keep in mind that the love of a Father that is so true as His Imperial Majesty to Gieta Jesus Christos is one in which just that immense love cannot allow Him to even take on any kind of recognition, because his life, everything is His Son, and so may His glory shine through His Son. So let us continue. That was kind of like briefly, to not get into the whole technicalities of it or the actualities rather yet. And so let us go to another example of these tricksters, magic tricks and stuff like that. Luke chapter 15, verse 31. And He said to them, Son, thou art ever with me, and all that I have is thine. You see, this is not only like a lesson in the quantum of languages, the quantums of language and the mathematics of language, but this is a definite reference to, we might even have to do a video to explain the whole, not explain, but to share our testimony to the eternity. You see, it's, once again, it's referring to, and He said to him. So check this out. So, and he said to him, "Man, yours," and then there be some standing here. Those all mean the same thing. They only mean you, ye, you right here, you present, and you standing, you affirmed, you upright. That I guess that's a better connection with the whole affirmation with you that stand upright, that you whom yea is yea, and is not, you know, going to the left or to the right, but keeping straight. And yeah, you know, His Pure Majesty is God the Father. I don't care what you think. But many of us, you know, and we personally have done it, but I mean, all thanks to a really good question, that will not be so from hence on. We shall never compromise anymore, regardless of who might feel bad and stuff like that. So, you know, that's kind of like a defining our standing of those present. Because, and even if we go beyond that, if you're not standing affirmative and you're in that straight and narrow way, you know, if you're not a pillar set upright, then you're not present there. So it don't. So ones would pretend that, oh, this means you here, and it means everyone and stuff like that. Nah, because some are not present. Some aren't even. Some are just like chaff that the wind blow away. And so it's a vanity, and they've never been, never will be. And so it's kind of like probably like an illusion to, you know, to make us what we have to be. And that's pretty cool, you know. And it seems sad sometimes because you look at everyone around and you're kind of like, wow, you're just like your purpose is to, you know, is to just you're a sacrifice for like all Rastafari to get their act together. Basically, it's what it comes down to. And so yeah, I mean, much to talk about, but and just to, okay, I'm just gonna say this. It has nothing to do, kind of, but just for those that aren't really all that interested in God the Father and His Christ Jesus, think about it. Who is? Cause we're not this because we're good or anything, right? It's we're trash. We're like dirty rags, but it's Jesus Christus, and in Him we're not dirty rags. You know, we don't deserve this, but in and through Jesus Christus we do. And so let us not get down on ourselves because we do deserve this, but only in and through Christ Jesus. And so, but for all the rest, it's like you might have a good job, you might have a career, you might make some money, you might be a good person, so-called. You might actually be fairly decent and successful and stuff like that. But how many people like that are in the world? Many. But how many people, you know, affirm with all with no objection and no what's it called? With no condition and just as it being what it be, the test who testifies to God the Almighty, the Creator, and you know, it's Rastafari, and we should, at least we should. And so think about it. How many people like those are in the world? Very few. And so who is the Almighty Creator going to take most consideration towards? I mean, you that have a good job and stuff like that, but forgot, I mean, who cares how you got whatever it is that you got? How do you breathe? Who breathes for you? I mean, what do you breathe? And so everyone, basically, the world gets caught up in their own vanity, like yeah, I got all of this because I worked hard, because even if you say, oh yeah, thanks to my parents, but your parents may have carried you in their arms, but who is carrying them? Who allows them to live? Like if they were in complete control of that, when's the last time you told yourself to breathe? Now, just think about it. And so you're not in control at all. And so this is kind of like to if ones can receive it as a motivation to kind of like seek to do the will of God Almighty. And it's things are so bad that even us that are, you know, like the worst of the worst, get to share and get to be in a good relationship with the Almighty. And even though it shouldn't be that way, but because we in this case we are the minority and the elect few, you know, it allows for it to be so. And not to mention, our worthiness in and through Geta Yesu. And so, and that's also interesting because we could have stuck to, we're going to keep saying Haile Selassie or Haile I or whatever. But no, we listened. We said, all right, the Father wants us to, that's, I mean, personally, at first we were kind of like, okay, that's kind of weird, but, you know, that's God right there. So, I mean, he's saying go to Jesus Christ. We'll go look into it. And even that is much to really meditate upon. It's like, personally, it was weird. It's kind of like, what? But if he's God, if he's, why is he sending us to the, what time and study you overstand the situation, but many continue in vanity and be, nah, you're God. We don't deal with Christ. And so just think about it for them that want to. And so let us continue. We apologize, but it was necessary to allow for once an opportunity to make their wills obedient to good influence, and then to listen to the good influence. You know, like in this case, His Majesty says that all is in Christ Jesus, and go to Christ Jesus. You know, is that's what he said. That's what we do. So continuing, another example would be, let's go to John chapter 8, verse 5. We don't remember what that is, but... Oh yeah, this is the stones, probably. Chapter 5. Now Moses in the law commanded us that such should be stoned, but what sayest thou? Okay, do the math now. We have, what sayest thou? There be some standing here, and the other one, there's another verse, we forgot it. They all mean the same thing. So do the math, and how, do the numbers, and how easy it is for an unlearned world to be manipulated and enslaved by the few that, not that they're smart or anything, but that they've been passed down the wickedness of their deeds, of the ancestral deeds, you know. They're not any better. They just know that they're lying to you. That's simple as that. So let us go to 2 Timothy. And this is really, 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 well, we know why, but, you know, we'll just put it out there. And we're not picking these. These are actually all referenced in Blue Letter Bible. So just to give better explanations and examples of the different ways that this one word could be put to use. And the word, check this out. The word is human, and the root word is actually, well, the next word is humase, and so I'm thinking humane, and then the root word is, it's sue. So, I mean, it's I guess that's kind of where they could get away with putting man in there, just because ones would kind of, even if they go as far as to even look it up, they'll read human. And so you see, these wicked individuals are hoping that you continue in your ignorance, is what we're thinking. So let us continue with 2 Timothy. Let us do chapter 2, verse 1 to 3. Thou therefore, my son, and that would probably be the one, that therefore, my son, another, so now we have, what, 30 words for one definition? Goes to show. Be strong in grace that is in Christ Jesus, and the things that thou hast heard of me among many witnesses, the same commit thou to faithful men, which is what Indi is trying to do, who shall be able to teach others also, which now the viewer, is it's up to you to continue to pass it forward, or whatever that movie was called, pass it forward or something. Nonetheless, continuing, it's only a ripoff. Everything's a ripoff of the word. So, you know, let's not credit movie makers with that idea. Verse 3, thou therefore endure hardness as a good soldier of Jesus Christus. Now, 2 Timothy chapter 3, verse 10. But thou hast fully known my doctrine, manner of life, purpose, faith, long-suffering, charity, and patience. We may not know exactly who we are, but we know our Father. And because we know our Father, we know why we're positioned in the place that we are positioned. We know why we are descended from what it is that we are descended from. We know why we are so-called from whatever so-called nation we are from. Nation means born, that's it. Anyways, we know why we look the way we look, it, and it all serves to make fully filled, to fulfill the grand design that the Almighty has for each and every one of us. And so it's no surprise. We'll leave that at that. But let us add this. I mean, get over the physical appearances and get over, I mean, this is real. This is as real as can be. And so continuing, let us do a last one, and it's Hebrews verse 11. We didn't want to take too much time to allow more people to want to watch the video, but this is good stuff, you know. So Hebrews chapter 1 verse 11, and it reads, they shall perish, but thou remainest, and they all shall wax old as doth a garment. And Kietayas is being our garment, we stand the test of time, and you know, the vain shall perish and I shall remain it. You know, there's much comfort in that. So, okay, let us, basically that would just prove that man isn't even in there. So there's, technically, there is no need to have to go to the rest. But, and then you, okay, just putting this out there, you, as in, like, you, oh, you went there, or you have $50 or something, you means no also, so just for future reference. And patar, okay, father does not mean the progenitor, in this case does not mean the creator. This is referring to calling your teachers, your spiritual mentors, your whatever, just elder people, your ancestors, fathers. It's that kind of father. It's not like saying creator. More clearly, we think it's referring to, because of the evidence, it's referring to calling, like, oh, the father of modern physics, like if he created or originated the modern physics, and oh my. Our father Jerry, the originator of the society of this, or of the clan of that, or the tribe of this. And so it's like, those aren't fathers, you know. We are not to be doing that, and there is so much behind that. We got to go into it. It's because upon earth, and so earth would be your standing, and your standing upon the world, and so up on is epi is putting before, over, against. It neglects elision before proper names begin with vowels. So okay, that's confusing, but what it does, it's epi. It lowers your standard. It makes you vulnerable to enslavement because you have declared and testified to being less than an equal of a being, of existing. And so you're standing upon calling, oh, the father of physics. You are exalting and actually making manifest a higher standing than that of yourself by calling someone Father Jerry. And so Your standing upon earth has been diminished to slavery, to merchandise, to property, to it's vulnerable to anything. And so epi is funny because and it reminds me of Spanish, apa. You know, it's like my dad or like mi apa, and then epi apa, it's like mi apa Javier or whatever. In this case, it would be like like my dad Xavier, or Abher, but okay, bad example. It's like saying Father Wilson. It's Epi Apa Wilson, you know. And so it's the same thing. What it comes down to is that you are in fact diminuting your standing. You are no longer upright, and you are not even qualified to affirm, to make an affirmation. So you are no longer in good land. You're no longer in standing in arable land. Now you are, you know, lost at sea. You know, hoping to dock in a foreign port and being taken as merchandise. And so let us conclude there. The rest is not necessary. So we give thanks for those that take the time to watch the video. Shalom, Rastafari.